You having dinner with Steve Miller once, and he told you about the pompous of love.
Yeah, well, have you? Oh, yeah. We haven't done this for a while. Six degrees of Eddie Maguire. So, how quickly can you connect yourself to Steve Miller?
Let me think. Okay, I'll come back to you with that one.
Okay, all right, we'll come back.
I haven't got a direct route to
all right. Mick Jagger.
He'll get there. It's okay. He'll get there.
I knew you were going. I was trying to help you there, mate.
Yeah, Mick it in.
Can I roll this?
I have one night where I did look across with. I was having some after concert dinner and drinks with Mick Jagger and Ronnie Wood.
Where was Keith?
Where's Keith?
Keith was
somewhere cool.
No, Keith was next to me on the next table. With
next table?
Yeah, right next to it. Was only us.
Oh, and he didn't make the main table, Keith.
Yeah. Keith was at the kids' table.
This is what happened. It was in New York City after I actually got an escort back with the Rolling Stones.
Oh, you got an escort?
From New Jersey.
Very rock and roll.
The boss was also with us.
And Carla?
She was absolutely with us.
Bruce Springsteen? Or?
And apparently yes. Olsteen.
And Bruce and Gary Clark Jr. as well. He was up. Mm-hmm. He was there.
Gary Clark Jr. was there?
He was there. And then we went back to New York City and we're having some private drinks and some food. James Young's nose was pressed against the wall.
James Young was there?
He was outside. Okay. Yeah, and But it was an interesting, it actually was an interesting dinner because it was the Stones, their respective families, and Johnny Depp was sitting with
Johnny Depp.
Oh, sorry, you've dropped another one.
Johnny Depp was there with Keith. I looked across, it was quite surreal. I had to look past the woman who was sitting next to me, Lady Gaga, to see it.
Oh my God.
Yeah. What is happening?
It's what happened.
This is...
It's absolutely
even
true.
By your standards, even, this is...
How many names have you managed to get into this?
I'm only saying who was sitting at my table. That was
you know what? We're going to have to actually run this break back, and I'm going to have to put a little bell on every time a name is dropped.
Well, there was Carla, myself, and it was Paul and Donna Dainty, and then the associate cast around us there.
Okay. Oh, the stragglers.
I was talking to Ronnie Wood about...
what are you talking to Ronnie Wood about?
I talked to him about Rod Stewart when they were in the Faces together, and of course, their early days, because there's a great autobiography, written by Rod Stewart that has a lot of Ronnie Wood in it.
Okay.
Did you ask him about the Doobie Brothers?
No, I didn't get to the Doobies. No.
What did you chat to Mick about?
I talked to Mick about cricket, actually, a little bit. Yeah, because he's right into his cricket. We're talking about the cricket and, some of the other things. We actually spoke about his tours in Australia, how much he's loved them, going back to
1973,
which we'll get to at Kooyong. But very intelligent.
Lady Gaga. What did you chat to Lady Gaga about? What did you and Gaga have a Gaga about?
Didn't have a long conversation with Lady Gaga. She was involved in other conversations and I didn't want to interfere. She was having a good time.
Did you not want to interfere?
No, we were talking.
That's the least believable part of this whole story that you didn't interfere in someone's
Lady Gaga was there and
couldn't get a Collingwood jumper on her, so you moved on.
And Charlie Watts was next to her on the next side.
Oh, there we go, another one. Charlie.
Well, just the full
asked about Steve Miller, and I regret it now.
I would have thought that Lady Gaga, you're talking to, Mick about cricket, you're talking to...
Lady Gaga, as I speak.
Lady Gaga.
Yeah.
Well, she famously wore a meat dress.
Mm. Yes.
To an awards ceremony. Which, and you,
would have been all over that.
Yeah. If she'd been there in the meat dress, you would have been interested.
I actually did have one small conversation with her where I spoke to her about her close association and the support she received from Elton John.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay, great. Because you know Elton as well.
Have you met Elton?
Yeah, well, of course I know Elton. Elton dedicated a song to him in his Melbourne concert.
Shut up.
He did to me.
No way.
Absolutely. And the concert.
Candle in the Wind?
No.
And Warnie.
To Warnie, because we saw him backstage. But I did, of course, hosted James Packer's wedding.
Yeah.
And Elton was the guest there. And so we knew each other.
You knew each other, did you?
Yeah. And
1-3-5-3.
Bob Halley became a good friend of mine who used to be his manager.
Halley.
Yeah.
What did you speak to Lady Gaga about? Yeah. Give us a call 1-3-5-3.
Yeah.
That'll resonate out there.
Ask a question.
Both you and Lady Gaga served behind the bar at Cherry Bar.
Oh,
there we
did. You could have talked about that.
Yeah, we could have. I wasn't aware of that. But there you go. 10 to 6, 10 to 8. Anything else you want to ask?
That'll do it, I think.